wanted to show you the reason for some of the things that we do here. So if you notice here, we have started to use in all of our Milwaukee 8s the new S&S piston jet oilers. They're a dual hole piston jet oilers that they do disperse the oil underneath the piston a little better than the single one. So I strongly recommend those. So, and then as you can see here, this case has our scraper in it. You can see it's our scraper that we machine into the case and everything, and you'll see all the black marks. And then if you look down into your case, you'll see I initial that and okay. That lets you guys know that everything was tight. But that's what all, you'll see all these white marks on everything. And that's just to ensure you guys that I torqued everything. It's just kind of a reminder for me as well. So then we flip over here to the other side. And you can see here we use a flat face pinion screw to put ours in. So it does not stick up any higher than what the case does. Okay. And then you can see here we paint those. And then this is our reed valve. Now this is something that we have done since day one. Now I know there's a lot of guys that would debate the seal on the oil pump, and I don't even really like to call it a seal. I like to call it more of a reed valve, because if you look at this, you can see it right here. This is a flexible piece right here, okay? So it does the same thing as what our reed valve does. We're a firm believer in the seal. We run it on all of our S&S pumps, just so you know. Now, in our video, the previous video though, the one thing that I did mention to you is the placement of this bearing. That is very, very crucial. And I can't express that enough, because what will happen is, if this bearing is sitting too high, then when you put the pump in, what it does, it smashes that seal, and it does, let's not call it a seal, let's call it our reed valve. It smashes it and does not allow it to work. So the placement of this bearing is very crucial, and that's what I wanted to mention to you in our other video. So when you put this in, when this all goes in and everything, the pump is pulled down, that seal should just rest right there on it, and it should be sealed like so. It shouldn't be, you know, tight to where it's pressed in like that. If it does, it's useless. You can't get the pressure out or the pressure in. So the placement of this bearing is very crucial. So anyways, I just wanted to kind of show you that's what it should look like. And then when that pistons come down, it will blow that lip out, letting the pressure out. And then when they go up, it sucks it up against the bearing and closes it. Now, one of the things that you will notice, and this is one of the things I hear a lot of people talk about. Now, when you put the cylinders on and you're rotating the motor around, when those pistons come down to bottom dead center, you'll feel that thing kind of just hesitate a minute. But you got to keep in mind, you're not moving that flywheel assembly like it would be when it's running. It's not opening that seal, okay, even if it's only got a little bit of pressure on it. So please understand, you will feel what I call like a little hit at the bottom, and that's when the pistons come down and it's trying to blow that pressure underneath the flywheels into the cam cover area. So you will feel that, and if it's real tight, if this seal is real tight, it's even worse. So keep in mind, that's just the way that we do it. Thank you.